Hey guys, welcome back to Oxygen Not Included, Clay's Amazing Space Colony Adventure Extraordinaire. My name's Twitchi and we are in Twitchi's Tremendous Trojans. I recently had a playthrough, lasted about a couple of hours, but honestly all I ever did was doing things that we've seen before. So if you will indulge my Gallifreyan instincts, we're going to do a little bit of time jumping around here. I started the session, of course, with checking out the cold water, because of course, what else am I going to check out? But whilst doing that, Ruby actually brought to our attention that our power was starting to have a few little issues. The underlying cause for the power was the fact that our top gas generators were not working due to the gas geyser being dormant. And down below, despite having two gas geysers, we only had two generators. So the first job was to double that out. Whilst my camera was down in that side of the asteroid, I noticed that the second cold chamber had not been touched for a very long time. So I started telling people to dig that out as well. Whilst all these things were being taken care of and looking around my base, I noticed that we were still having a few oxygenist issues. I bought a whole brand new electrolyzer system over in the swamp biome, because you know, swamp biomes don't lead to any problems at any point ever, do they? Whilst I was doing that, the one new thing that I actually did do was put some carpet in the Patreon's bedroom, so nice new things for you. Now really, the last exciting thing that I did in that entire session was to dig for some algae. And as the intro music conveniently comes to an end during the next title screen, I welcome you back to Twitchi's Tremendous Trojans. Yes, we're going to do this next session instantly. Hope you guys don't mind the little sum up we did beforehand, but I got to the end of the session and I was literally like, what have we done different here? I can't release a video that's just this. So the next session starts with going over and checking the new electrolyzer system. It seems to be going well and we've got an awful lot of oxygen in the base. I've noticed there's a lot of hangovers from previous starter base. Just kind of kicking around things like manual generators inside the base, so we're gonna get rid of that stuff. And we're also going to start the research for transit tubes, because the hot biome down below is a long way, and that's one of the places that people seem to go to a lot to produce the oil. And eventually we're going to put the new metal refining setup down there so that people can have fast transit in and out of the system, and it should all work out. And then like everything that is all horrifically nasty down there can just stay down there. Another thing that I think is a bit of a hangover is the power system for the slime distillery. You can see that we are already starting to take that out, but actually made a little bit of a mistake by telling them to take out the bottom ladder. I will realize this at some point. You might remember that a long time ago we actually started digging out some slime down to the bottom right. I'm not sure why they've decided that now is the time to tidy that up, but obviously their list of priorities has worked through to that. I tried moving Mad Frank because I've actually set Sir Steve as the head research assistant there. It doesn't seem to actually be Sir Steve that's doing that. Now, this obviously means it's actually a priority issue, and I need to go through and change that properly. Now, whilst Brum is fixing up the bottom of that floor, I watch all the things dropping from this little tunnel we're digging up, and I'm like, no. Let's just leave the bottom of the tank out, and then all the things can drop out and underneath. And then we've got no problems. It's not in the water. Talking of in the water, we are very close to having all the slime lung out of that top tank there. So we can then start pumping that through to the cold water tank where it's going to heat everything up. And then we've got to wait for it all to cool back down again. But, you know, that is the cycle of our recycling water at the moment. We have a little bit of an issue with our electrolyzer setup. I can't quite get the balancing just right. For some reason, we get a situation where either we've got too much oxygen in the system or the electrolyzers are max gassed. I never seem to have too much hydrogen. That is never an issue. But I go through, I set up some numbers, we spend some time watching it. I go, yeah, that looks fine. That looks like it's going to be absolutely sorted. And then when we come back to look at it like 15 minutes later, it's still not quite right. Okay, I want to try and dig through this this shaft, shall we call it, so that we can get the water coming from the cool gas geyser down into the chill biome, because that's going to give us a lot of water to deal with. And I think having a lot of water might be a good way. It will save us being so reliant on the recycling system. I will still be using the recycling system. That would then become like more of a background, a supplementary top-up system to the major one that we've got going. Of course, we will need to actually give priority to the recycling system so that we don't end up backing up in the waste waters, because that would be pretty terrible. Talking of wastewater, we've got all this water that we spilled much, much earlier on in the series, and I've not really done anything with it because I knew if we just waste waited long enough, it would actually become some clean water. And yes, it's become clean water, so it's time to start moving it around. It's unfortunately hot water as well, so we need to deal with the temperature. Whilst I'm just looking around the base quick, I'm going to make sure that everything is A-OK, make sure the gas levels are fine in the top left electrolyzer, start destroying a few things that don't need to be there, watch the water flow beautifully, and think about how to expand that right-hand cold water tank. We're definitely working on that slowly but surely. It's got a little bit of polluted water in it, so we need to try and clean all of that up. But the guys at the moment are busy cleaning up what I'm going to call the power room, or that's got the two transformers in it, and because I put that as a really high priority, I don't know why, I just decided that was the room that needed to be cleaned before we actually got round to moving all the buildings and stuff to get the pump in. You see, I'm in the middle of making a little bit of a well in the insulated tiles there. I put some tiles down below, and then I'm going to take out the ones above, so that hopefully I can get a nice water pump straight in there, and we can think about where it's going to flow. Now, my original plan was actually to throw it into the tank and be like, well, we just treat it like any other dirty water. But as it has essentially been sat in a tank already, I'm just going to pump it straight into the cold water tank. This might give us some troubles, but all in all, I think we're okay. The reason I wanted those guys to get rid of that snow that we just saw there was because there was a Weezwort hiding in the background amongst all the detritus, and we didn't want to lose it like underneath a single layer of tank. That'd become impossible to reach. Most of the Weezworts are now being put underneath electrolyzers, just in an effort to keep down the temperature of the oxygen that's being pumped into the base. I think it comes out at like 30 degrees, which is not terrible. It's not a terrible temperature to come out at, but I know if I survived at a 30 degree environment, I would very much want it to be closer to 21. Looking in this wall structure here that we've got set up, I'm in particular lifting the priorities of any polluted ice, because I want to get rid of any pollutants out of that whole cold water tank as fast as possible. Unfortunately, the duplicants seem to be much more interested in taking all the slime from the upper reaches down to the slime distiller, which I suppose is okay, and it does actually show me the problem I had by taking out the ladder before people could reach the upper areas of the things I wanted taken out, the manual generators and the gas power, not the gas power, sorry, the battery power. Okay, so all the pipes seem to be putting into place, but unfortunately, the heavy watt wire has not been fitted yet. We're waiting for, is that subs? It looked like subs up there, just to go and put the last couple of bits in place. Unfortunately, this is going to take a fair while to be done. There also seems to be a little bit of slime lung in there that I didn't quite notice, but you know, we will live with that. Despite the pump going at full flow, there is a lot of water to be moved from that holding pen there. You can see that there is many tiles, and each of those tiles contains at least 500 kilograms of water. The pump moves 10 kilograms of water per go. This is some pretty big numbers that I'm having to deal with here. Though for some reason decided I wanted to hang around and see if we could watch the water level drop. And even at this accelerated rate, it's quite hard to notice the water going down. The place you can spot it mostly is on the ladder on the right. If you watch there, you can see that individual rungs are slowly being exposed as the night goes on. I really wanted to just watch the last bit of water that I've just highlighted right there disappear. We can watch it go down, but with the advent of the next morning, I decided it was time to go across and start doing other jobs. The other job that we really wanted to watch here was this little water tank get cleared out, mainly getting the walls put down in place. But the main focus for today is going to be trying to work on these transport systems. We can see that there is a little bit of a problem with the way that I want to set them up. It turns out that the pipes need to have a single tile of traveling straight towards the stations here, if you will, before it can actually join up, which means almost everything that I've got set up is set up in the wrong way. I didn't quite notice it there because, as you saw, I kind of curved over and just went without really paying any sort of attention. And also, we've got these nice little through wall pieces, so that's pretty cool there. So right now I'm having a look, and I didn't quite click what was going on, how that maybe the entry station, are we going to call them entry stations? Yeah, we're going to call them entry stations and tubes, don't seem to be aligning up on that up the top system are there. Going back, the water unfortunately had already dropped down and we didn't get to see it do its thing, but it's all being pumped into the cold biome, and that's going to get nicely chilled out. The biome over here is being very nicely hollowed out. I'm essentially going to turn the entire biome into a cold water tank, somewhere for water to chill out. We need to get some extra systems in place to make sure that, you know, temperature is dissipated around quite well, but it's a good system that we seem to be putting into place. I'm also trying to isolate the different rooms that we have down below. Watching the slime lung level here, everything seems to be going in pretty well, actually. We're going to be looking to having an empty tank of slime lung at the top there, so that'd be pretty cool. Looking to see if we want to extend our buildings out, and yes I do. I want to extend these out to the right so we can put down a new refining process, because of course we have a lot of metals on the go at the moment, and we've built a lot of plastics as well, which is another advanced material. They both kind of go well together, and we need them for all the advanced building stuff. Anything that, you know, is a little more higher tier, we're gonna need both metals and plastics for, so that whole area down there seems to be working out pretty well. I noticed that we couldn't reach the walls, so I put down a whole bunch of ladders to help that process along, and we really want to just kind of solidify that outside boundary now to make sure that none of the ice around the outside is going to melt and ruin our day. There probably will still be troubles, let's be honest there. I can see lots of things going wrong. Everything from us over flooding the wall barrier, like on the right hand side there is obviously a hole to get into the tank, so maybe we'll flood it that way. There is a door on the bottom left, maybe something's going to go wrong there. There are plenty of ways to watch out. I was a little concerned with Wise going out and around that way, because I was fairly sure that I wanted to keep that area segregated from the duplicants, because there was a whole bunch of jobs there that all the duplicants seemed like super up for doing, but I didn't actually want them to go and do that. It's mainly like tidying and stuff like that, so that's a thing to watch out for, I believe. The water levels still are going down, still topping up the cold water tank, and the cold water tank's starting to pick up a bit of heat now. I'm going to put down a few more of these shift plates to see if we can like just kind of ease the temperatures around a bit more. Changing a few priorities for the deconstructions just to make sure things are working well, and I still seem not to have noticed that the pipe does not go into the top tube section. I'm not entirely certain how long it's going to take me to notice that now that I stop and think about it. I've got a feeling I'm going to build the entire system before I actually go, oh wait, why isn't this working? This could be a thing. But anyway, Mad Frank and Ruby down taking care of some of the big things that need taking care of here. Getting a real build on there. Took out most of the floor, and unfortunately this has left our man Mad Frank stranded on the other side of a big void, but we sorted that out pretty quickly, mainly by using a local materials to build down tiles, and then Mad Frank could deal with the whole tile process himself. It's a lot easier when you get the person who's stuck to save themselves rather than trying to get extra people in, because those extra people generally are off doing other jobs, and then you have to wait for them to get through their priority list, and that during that time the person who's stranded normally has like wet themselves or has started to starve or has got a serious environmental issue on the go or something like that. So yeah, generally best to deal with the people who are actually stranded themselves. I find it really interesting that people just keep wanting to go up and down that ladder over there. I thought everything would be isolated away, so we're going to try and do something about that. We're going to rip the ladder down, in fact, to try and do something about that. And I was having a look at these tubies here and noticing that things were not connecting. Indeed, right here, the realization has struck me. I want to take down that little tube entry system. Yes, that's what we're going to call it. And if by moving it down one block, we have room to turn the tubes around. And maybe we'll get some sort of T-junction in place and we can extend the system out and around. But that's fine. I did notice that one of the materials that I had built my temperature shift plates with was covered in slime lung. And also, when the water level dropped in the top tank, because it had no germs in it, it then let in some more germs from the water pump system, which I didn't think should be able to do a thing, but it turns out it was, because the water level dropped and then it gave the system off. So we need a logic system on that is what I'm trying to say here, and I'm not sure exactly how we're going to build that. But I will go and have a bit of a play. What we want is to have a hydro sensor at the bottom, right? So that it can say when it's empty. Yeah, we'll have a hydro sensor at the top that turns it off, and then a hydro sensor at the bottom that turns it back on. And then maybe some sort of T flip-flop. I don't know if T flip-flops are part of the logic system here, but we will definitely be able to build one. All right, putting the last pieces in place for this transport system, and hopefully we'll get everything going nicely. Putting down a few of the furniture items that are obviously needed here, and also powering. Power is a very important part of the system that I, for some reason, completely forgot would need to exist. But no, it's fine, because mainly we put these stations down on top of heavy watt wire already, so that's no problem. Coming back to the ever-evolving problem of, you know, just this whole section over here, the main thing that's going on are people putting down, or duplicants, putting down containments for the cold steam gas geyser. It's a bit of a long-form name for that up there. I might just call it the steam geyser from now on. I think we all know what I mean by that. Thankfully, we don't have an incredibly hot system. One thing that I do to try and increase the holding capacity of the cold water tank is just to move the vent up a little bit, the water vent up a little bit. So that should hopefully give us an extra two layers of spread space. So that'd be pretty cool. I go and queue up another bit of research here, catalytics. Not that I know what they're being used for. And also there appears to be a bunch of polluted water on the floor that I'm not sure entirely where it came from. I'm going to assume that it was moving polluted ice. This is why I wanted to keep the duplicants away from the cold biome up above, because they kept on moving polluted ice from these biomes over to the storage container that we have by the other cold biome. It took me a little while to figure out this crossing system, but we've had our first pipe use, by the way. Look at that, beautiful. The tube system is underway and we can start expanding that network out and around. But that's kind of like the big thing we did today, so yay, big thing done. Now we get back to worrying about the cold and hot waters, because that is my entire life in this game, it turns out. If anybody has a better way of dealing with the game, let me know. So as well as doing all that, I decide that the metal refinery is suddenly something to be concentrating on. I'm worried about the temperature of this whole area. Obviously, it gets quite hot, so we're going to start building everything out of high temperature materials. And with the closing off of the system, we notice that it's time to start digging now. And yes, we're going to let water flow in here. The whole area was relatively clean. It turns out I'd missed a single piece of polluted ice, but that's fine. Nothing that we can't deal with a quick mop, and the whole water flows. And hopefully now, all that's going to happen is steam is going to come out of that gas geyser up there, going to condense in the condensing shaft and drop down into the cold biome to chill out. And hopefully the fact that it will travel as tiny water droplets will help it cool down quickly. That's kind of my hope here. And we're going to just dump that straight into the main water tank, because you know what? We don't need to clean it. It's already clean. One thing I've noticed is that shine bugs are trying to like make their way. They diffuse ever so slowly from our ranching area. And I kind of like that, actually. What I'm going to do is set up a whole bunch of capture stations for shine bugs and like round the outside of my base. And then when they get caught, will go back to the ranching area where they can diffuse back out through the base and make the whole area lovely. I think that's actually not the worst plan I've ever come up with. I'm going to make use of that. A small little overhaul of the power system down here. I feel like it just needs just a little bit of work, nothing serious. But of course, we've got Brum stuck on the wrong side of a wall again. Brum, it's always you, but I think that's because, you know, you're the man doing all the work, right? That kind of makes sense. You are one of our most major developer guys, the people that go around and do the actual building, so that's pretty cool. The majority of the power system, of course, is for the cold water tank, the secondary cold water tank, even though I'm going to start calling that the primary cold water tank at some point. We're just putting in the final pieces. Of course, we need to get all the pipes in place to get the water up to the tank. That's a fairly self-evident piece of engineering that needs to happen. I think we can all agree on that. But of course, we then also need the power system down there, and it's a much easier thing to move the thin wires than it is to move the heavy watt wires, so I put down a transformer, that's the word I'm looking for there, a transformer there to take all the power away for us. That should be pretty cool. Put down some ladders, because what I want to do is open up the space around that gas geyser a little bit to try and encourage the water flow. And I'm probably actually going to have to make a little bit of a slanty system now that I think about it to encourage the water down towards the drop shaft a little bit more. You can see that the water vent did not get constructed the past couple of days. That's a little bit of a disappointment to me, because this means now our wastewater system is going to start backing up a little bit, and this always a concern. If our wastewater isn't being processed, that means our toilets are backing up, and I don't know about you guys, I think backing up toilets is probably one of the worst things we can have happening in this game. All right, cool. So people are using the whole transport system rather well, and I've gone ahead and ripped down the rock granulizer, because it's archaic technology from you know, the time before we had any decent technology. One thing I do know is that people don't really want to use the transport tube if they're in the corridor with the ladders already. So we might have to try and figure out some way of dropping a transport network entry exit point somewhere further in that stairway corridor, ladder corridor, whatever this main transport trunk is that I have here. Okay, people taking their time going up and doing the gas geyser stuff. That's cool, the steam geyser stuff. That's cool, but it is one of the things that I want to prioritize. The reason I want to put that wall in is to make a slightly more contained environment for the water to condense in. That should be working out pretty well. And I figure out that one of the problems here is access, so we get our diggers down to move the abyss light. I think at the moment the only one that's actually qualified is Zedtech and maybe Shrouticus as well. So these high tier dig drops, we've got to wait for 2 out of 14 duplicates, so it's going to take a little while. Have a look around at the gas, everything looks good, and I really want to clean up the water in this side tank that we seem to be building here. I think it would be nice to be able to suddenly expand this large tank out. Where did all that water come from? Of course, it came from the storage container that was full of polluted oxygen, polluted ice. That was kind of actually something that I wanted to happen, but I wasn't expecting to have it happen right there. I wanted to move it somewhere else for that to happen. I was expecting it to happen, expecting in the cold biome that it would stay cold. But of course, we've got all the hot water in there, and you know, this is a game of infecting your environment, so that's a thing. I've got a bit of a logic puzzle down the side. I've got to be putting an apology out there to you guys. We've been a little lax on the exploration for the past couple of episodes. Been fixated quite strongly on getting these refinement jobs done, which, you know, I think we all agree is needed for the colony, but we could have had the whole asteroid exposed by now, and I feel a little bit sad that we've not done that. Mad Frank doing his searching job analyzing job on the gas geyser, the steam geyser there, so hopefully everything will be working out a-okay. And one of the things we need to do is get water and such other materials moving from the metal refinery, because it consumes one liquid and outputs some very, very hot version of that liquid. I'm using water. I don't know if there's another system that would be better. I don't know. It's my first time experimenting with this high-tech metal refinement. Normally I just make do with the rock granulizer, because there's so much metal I don't mind getting rid of half of it, especially when you then go up to space and they start like raining materials down upon you. And I believe you can like change the regolith into stuff, but you might notice that we're having a little bit of trouble over with the cold water tank now that we've shifted our camera view, but whatever. A lot of the ice above it is starting to melt, and it's making quite a bit of liquid there that we have to deal with, so I'm gonna watch out for that. All the duplicants seem to be grabbing the materials from inside that power station there. I'm fine with that, because it means we're actually clearing out the area, so yeah, let's keep on doing things like that. I'm a little disappointed with the amount of water that just appears to be everywhere. I really need to go through and do quite a few mop jobs. Also, the amount of polluted water that seems to be seeping through the walls or something like that. Every time I look at the big water tank, the one to our left, there seems to be just a little bit of polluted water in the bottom left, and I don't actually know where it's coming from. It just keeps turning up. I thought we'd sealed this entire place off so this wouldn't happen. Look, turns out it's happening. Maybe these tiles aren't as impermeable as I thought they were. Maybe, I don't know. We'll have to run some experiments and find out. So right now, during the gameplay, I'm kind of pulling my hair out. I'm just like looking at this small little section of stuff that needs to be done. And the fact that the duplicants are taking so long about it is really starting to get to me. Especially as I'm looking at the cycle time, and we are getting very close to having another timeout. And in fact, here it goes, downtime has struck. And we just got to wait for people. There's a lot of water being dropped in the floor here, and I'm not entirely sure where it came from. I think when I was ripping down a few pipes, that might have happened there. Taking a look at the temperature distribution, it's kind of going all right, you know, just waiting for it all to seep out and mix with the cold biome, because the cold biome, of course, nullifies a little bit of the temperature, and we do actually have the anti-entropy bloody blah nullifier machine up to the top right. I'm wondering whether we could actually build a tank around that and then drop water directly upon it. And why had I never thought about this during the actual gameplay? That would be pretty cool. I bet we'd end up with a lot of ice very, very quickly. I'm also wondering whether you could then, like, take that ice that you would inevitably form, break it somehow, or with the automatic miners, pick it up, put it in some sort of like storage container where it gets hot next to whatever your hot room is, whether you've got like your refining room or something like that, and then you have your hot tank there. I don't know, maybe your main tank, sorry, so it could just warm up. That would be very nice. Definitely something to go exploring with once we've got this entire system set up and like we're feeling comfortable and self-sustainable. We can then like move all the water from down here up to the anti-entropy stealing temperature device. Maybe that's the way we'll do it. I don't know. It's long way ahead yet. And what I'm trying to do at the moment is figure out how this metal refining works. Now, of course, it is taking in liquids. It's going to output some very hot liquids. I've put some insulated pipe down, but I'm not sure where we're actually going to end up outputting the liquids because they're going to be very, very hot. And I do have some cold tanks, but I'm not sure if I want to dump them in the cold tanks because it's very, very hot. I don't know. We'll have to figure out stuff about that moving forwards because I think we are getting very close to the end of this game session. Today we have unleashed the raw power of the transport tubes. We could probably do with expanding that network out, but you know, we have started expanding the transport network out. We have got our more high-tech metal refining on the go. Sir Steve doing the work there. And I suppose really this just leaves me to say thank you very much for joining me for this adventure, ladies and gentlemen. I will see you next time where we're going to do a little bit of exploration. The water should be done and we will see what other wonders are out there. If you have any suggestions, do let me know in the comments, and we're reaching the point where I could very easily like just stagnate into a pool of self-sustainability. So if you have ideas, do let me know and we will go and do those. But I'll see you then when we're gonna do that. Bye.